Homegrown technology turns pollution into energy and creates a slew of green jobs. Welcome to Future 360. I'm Sarah Backhouse. What if you could generate clean, renewable power while at the same time cleaning up pollution-causing greenhouse gases? We've come to Portsmouth, New Hampshire, to the manufacturing plant of Flex Energy, a clean tech company that's creating an energy solution while solving an environmental problem.
Brett Ludi, Director of Business Development at Flex Energy. With our technology, what we're doing is taking a man-made problem, landfilling, wastewater, and eliminate the pollution aspect of it and generate energy to power our society.
The company's core products are the Flex Power Station and Flex Turbine. Both create emissions-free energy from previously unusable, harmful greenhouse gases like methane, which is 25 times more potent than carbon dioxide. The technology works by integrating existing microturbine technology with a proprietary thermal oxidizer.
John Alday, Vice President of Engineering. This oxidizer allows us to convert very lean waste gases that contain methane anywhere from 100% all the way down to about 5% into energy. And it does this in an extremely clean fashion so that the emissions from the machine are the lowest that are available of any technology today.
Hi, I'm Jake, and I'm a controls engineer at Flex Energy. Engineering is everything. There's a science to this, to combustion and oxidation, but to make it work requires a whole lot of engineering. So what we have right here, for instance, is some temperature control code that we've written, and we're making sure that all of the enables, all the alarms, and all of the numbers are doing what they should do.
One of the most important applications of Flex technology is its ability to transform methane from landfills, like this one in Burbank, California. Up until now, methane was simply flared, causing combustion-related pollution. But now it's creating clean, green energy. And there are many other groundbreaking applications too.
I'm Tom Hayek. I'm the CEO and the owner of Taurus Energy LLC, and we distribute the Flex Energy products in Russia. Well, Russia is a major exporter of energy, and in the process of getting the energy out of the ground, there's quite a bit of flared gas that's being burnt off today, and the Russian government has decreed that gas should be used for something useful rather than burnt into the atmosphere.
With its modular design, Flex Energy can be scaled up to suit any site.
The machines are 250 kilowatts of output. That's equivalent to powering between 200 and 250 homes per unit. And they can be installed in modular clusters, so you can scale up to, you know, 500 kilowatts, 1 megawatt, and so on and so on, and utilize these fuels to create continuous clean renewable power in localized settings.
This innovation is also creating green jobs for America's workforce.
I'm Mark Schnuppel. I'm the Director of Manufacturing at Flex Energy. We're one of the few places in the area that is hiring at the rate that we're hiring. We're going to be adding probably 20 additional direct workforce technicians and assemblers by the end of the year. It's great to know that, you know, we're putting people to work that might have been out of work for a year or longer.
Technicians, electricians, materials purchasing, and quality control. Clean tech manufacturing is putting the country back to work.
If we're truly going to make sustainable societies, we have to do localized power, we have to use all the resources at our disposal, and make good things come from the waste products. And if we can use that, now we're talking about true sustainability.
It's very rewarding to know that you're giving something back and that I'm going to leave the environment potentially a little bit cleaner than when I came into the world.
Flex's future looks bright as the company continues to discover new applications for this exciting technology. From landfills to oil fields, converting harmful pollutants into clean energy is a compelling solution to tomorrow's energy and environmental needs.